Emoticons are racist. Maths is racist. Showing up on time is racist. Having a family is racist. You know what else is racist? Skincare products. According to BuzzFeed, skin whitening products reinforce
white supremacist ideals of beauty.
White supremacist ideals of beauty. That's so problematic.
So Nivea Philippines has a whole line with products like UV whitening body serum, extra white firming body lotion, instant white firming body lotion.
All right, here we go again. People in Asia are obsessed with skin whitening because stretching back to ancient China and Japan, a white complexion was seen as noble and aristocratic because it proved you weren't a peasant toiling out in the field all day under the hot sun. And maybe if you'd listened to the Asian woman in your own frigging video explain this to your face, you'd know that.
Because where they grew up, like socioeconomically, the farmers were dark-skinned, and farming wasn't a highly paid profession. And if you had more money or you were like part of the upper class, you would stay indoors and you would have an office job.
As far back as 700 BC, Chinese women would use ground-up pearls as a white face powder to give them a lighter complexion.
White supremacist ideals of beauty.
What the fuck does that have to do with white supremacy in a contemporary racial context? Nothing. Why do you think Japanese tourists walk around under umbrellas in the blazing sun? It's a cultural and socioeconomic class thing, not a race thing.
White supremacy.
It has nothing whatsoever to do with white people as a race or white supremacy. It's the same reason white people from Europe and colder areas of America go to tanning salons. It has nothing to do with race. Having tanned skin doesn't mean you're trying to reinforce black supremacy, does it? Just like Asians, only in reverse, they're deliberately trying to make their skin color darker. Because culturally and socioeconomically, it broadcasts a message of health and success. But wait, if white people are trying to make their skin look darker, does that mean sunbeds are cultural appropriation? And if white people who don't want a tan use sunscreen, does that make them racist?
White supremacist.
Now I'm just giving BuzzFeed ideas for their next video. The demand for skin whitening products is all coming from non-white people. Companies who cater to this demand are engaging in what's called free market capitalism. It has nothing to do with white supremacy.
White supremacist.
The only people who are not knowingly buying skin whitening products are white people. Yet out of all the different people in the video, whose awkwardness and shame did BuzzFeed choose to linger on? And it's the white girl.
So you're gonna tell me what's wrong?
That's racist!
Skin brightening products are sold in different markets very differently. So stuff that's sold in North America as like a brightener or something that exfoliates your skin to give you like this glowing complexion, in other markets overseas are often sold as whitening products.
White people who do buy what are described as skin brightening products use them to even out skin tone and hide blemishes. And so do some black people. Like the one in your video.
They do have issues with acne.
Are they doing it to jump on that oh so trendy and socially acceptable bandwagon of white supremacism?
White supremacist.
Or are they doing it to get rid of their acne? Oh, but the companies that sell those products use coded language and don't call them whitening products in America. Yeah, because they know if they did, they'd be descended upon by a mob outrage army of militant BuzzFeed readers accusing them of racism. That's why they don't do it. Not because they're orchestrating a giant global conspiracy to advance white supremacy by turning all the brown people into honkies.
White supremacy.
That's like saying spray on tan is a Black Lives Matter plot to secretly enact white genocide. One of the few times white women try to look whiter is when they're dressing up like Japanese geisha girls. Cultural appropriation! Really. Let's see what Japanese people think about the horror of being culturally appropriated. They don't give a shit because they haven't succumbed to the mass hysteria that everything you can possibly imagine is racist.
The real reason these products might be sold differently in different markets might actually have to do with what makes white consumers uncomfortable.
Yeah, you make them uncomfortable by blaming them for a white supremacist conspiracy that doesn't exist.
Ultimately, white people are uncomfortable with the idea that they might be engaging in white supremacist ideals of beauty, ones that suggest that if your skin is fairer, you're going to do better in life.
Okay, the example you just used to illustrate that claim, the racist Dove advert, was completely taken out of context. Now, don't take my word for it. The black woman who was the face of the commercial said it was completely taken out of context.
I was happy with it when I saw the ad itself because I turn into a white model, and then the white model turns into an Asian model.
Isn't this a bit of a fuss about nothing?
Yeah, that was the general gist of it.
The latter.
Like, yeah.
Oh, and if you really think skin whitening products are a form of white supremacy, why aren't you upset at black female entertainers like Beyonce, Azalea Banks, and Nicki Minaj? Because they all use them. Beyonce looks so white at this point that she's on the verge of going full Michael Jackson. Never go full Michael Jackson. People are gonna start asking her to check her white privilege, but holding anyone other than white people responsible wouldn't fit the narrative that every delusional injustice in the world is the fault of the evil crackers.
White supremacist.
So to summarize, skin whitening products reinforce
white supremacist ideals of beauty,
even though companies that sell them are just responding to the market demands of non-white people, even though barely any white people use them, even though way more white people use products to make their skin darker. And even though non-white people who use them do so for reasons that have nothing whatsoever to do with white people or race. Reasons like fixing their acne or socioeconomic and cultural factors that literally originated almost 3,000 years ago. But none of that matters because we're BuzzFeed and our entire business model depends on generating fake outrage by pretending that everything on the fucking planet is racist and that white supremacy rules the world. While we simultaneously use our dominant cultural supremacy to lecture white people about how bad they are and how they're to blame for everything. Please click the big red button to subscribe. It really helps me when you do that, and click the bell to allow notifications so you never miss a new video.